Welcome to our channel, my dear students. Today we are going to talk about the organic naming reaction. That is important organic naming reaction, which the part 4 we are going to discuss. We already discussed about the part 3 reaction, which we are discussed about many reactions. So here today is a part 2 going to discuss about these reactions like a Clemmensen reduction, Wolf-Kishner reduction, aldol condensation, cross-aldol condensation, Canizzaro reaction, Hell-Wallhar-Zinsky reaction, Cabriel-thalimide synthesis, and Hoffmann-Bromide degradation reaction. These are all the reactions today we are going to discuss. Let us discuss one by one. The first reaction is Clemmensen reduction. What is a Clemmensen reduction? Here the functional group conversion. So we have to look at when the conversion is asking. So here, if your C double bond O group is there, this is a carbonyl group, that C double bond O is getting converted into CH2. That time, if you want to convert C double bond O group into CH2 group, that time we have to use Clemmensen reduction. Okay, are you able to understand? So Clemmensen reduction already always taking place in presence of zinc amalgam HCl. So nothing but it's a kind of reducing agent, zinc, which will be merged in HCl, that liberate hydrogen gas, that time will be getting reduced product. So C double bond O will give CH2. That time I have to use Clemmensen reduction. So here it may be an aldehyde group or it may be a ketonic group. In what out may be that aldehyde or ketone, if carbonyl group is present, CO group is getting converted into CH2 group. That time respective product I will be getting as alkane. So here the reagent is zinc amalgam HCl. It's nothing but a reduction reaction. And next one is the Wolf-Kishner reduction. It is also a very, very simple one. What is the Wolf-Kishner reduction? Here also you can look at the C double bond O group. That is a carbonyl group of aldehyde or ketone. Okay, that will be taken. That carbonyl group is getting converted into CH2 again. So if you want to convert the CO group into CH2 group, at that time we have to use both the things, that is a Clemmensen reduction or Wolf-Kishner reduction. Here the thing is, if the reagent is where the, in that case, that is a Clemmensen reduction, we talk about a zinc amalgam HCl, but here Wolf-Kishner reduction, we use a hydrazine. So if you use a hydrazine, what kind of reaction may be taking place? So here it is nothing but the carbonyl carbon, oxygen and H2O, nothing but the elimination of a water molecule is there. If the water is getting eliminated like this, I will be getting a product, that is a NNH2, C double bond NNH2. So I will be getting, this is called a hydrazone. If I use the hydrazine here, I will be getting hydrazone as my intermediate. If I heat this intermediate hydrazone with the potassium hydroxide in presence of a high boiling solvent like ethylene glycol, that time this nitrogen is getting eliminated. Once the nitrogen is getting eliminated, I will be getting CH2 as a product. If I having RR or RH, at that time I will be having either, if I, this carbonyl group may be a aldehyde or may be a ketone, respective product I will be getting with the elimination of nitrogen. Now you can look at both the things, that is the Clemmensen reduction and Wolf-Kishner reduction. The only change is zinc amalgam HCl. Here also the reduction will be taking place. C double bond O group can be converted into CH2 group. My ultimate aim is to convert C double bond O into CH2. For that we can use both the reduction reaction, that is a Clemmensen reduction or Wolf-Kishner reduction. Both are reduction reaction, but the reducing agent is different. Here I use the hydrazine, here I use zinc amalgam HCl. Here one of the intermediate is getting formed like hydrazone. If I hydrazone is getting formed, I have to heat it with the KOH in presence of a high boiling solvent. That time I will be getting CH2 with the elimination of nitrogen. In both the case, in this case nitrogen is getting eliminated. In both the case I will be getting formed CO group into CH2 group. That is the ultimate aim for the conversion. And this is all about the Clemmensen reduction and Wolf-Kishner reduction. And next one is the very important naming reaction, that is called aldol condensation. So what is aldol condensation? So aldehyde group and alcohol group, that is aldehyde ol alcohol. Aldehyde group and alcohol group which is present in that product, that is what it may be called as aldol condensation. So two molecules of aldehydes or ketone with alpha hydrogen. So what about the two molecules? If the two molecules are same, that time I'll be getting aldol product. If the two molecules are different, but both may having alpha hydrogen or one of the molecule having alpha hydrogen, that time I'll be having cross aldol condensation. Let us discuss later. So here aldol condensation, the two same molecules of aldehydes are ketone with alpha hydrogen. That time I'll be getting product like aldol. So let us discuss here first molecule. What is that? CH3CHO. That is my ethanol. Ethanol will be reacting in presence of a dilute sodium hydroxide. The dilute sodium hydroxide, that time it will be acting as a base, that OH minus will always fix hydrogen. As you know that in organic chemistry, nucleophile always attacks carbon and the base always attacks hydrogen. If you don't know about this concept, please go and watch my previous video in aldol condensation mechanism in detail so we can get good idea about this. Here one which will pick the alpha hydrogen, that's what it create this kind of intermediate. This will be acting as a nucleophile. This nucleophile will attack the second molecule of this second molecule of ethanol. That time I'll be getting a intermediate. So if you hydrolyze this, I'll be getting the product like beta hydroxybutanol. So here the two carbon containing aldehyde is there and four carbon containing product is there. So here aldehyde functional group is there and here aldehyde functional group is there, alcohol functional group is there. Both the functional groups are there, that is what aldol condensation. Okay, so here aldol condensation is nothing but two molecule containing alpha hydrogen containing aldehydes or ketones. Okay, that will be going to react with this things. Okay, so I'll be getting two molecules of aldehydes and the product will be four molecule containing four carbon containing aldehyde with alcoholic functional group, that is called aldol product I'll be getting. Are you able to understand, students? I think so, you understand well. And next one is the cross aldol condensation. It is also a very simple one, but the thing is here we have to use two more conditions. What are the conditions? Let us discuss cross aldol condensation. From the word itself, cross aldol, that means two different aldehydes or two different ketones, or one aldehyde, one ketone, both the things may form a cross aldol condensation. If suppose here the condition is both should have alpha hydrogen, so here there will be a two conditions are there. If both the have both the aldehydes are ketones having alpha hydrogen, that time I'll be getting four different products. Suppose any one of the aldehydes or ketones will be having alpha hydrogen, one of the suppose if I'm taking the reactant one, the reactant one having alpha hydrogen, reactant two doesn't have alpha hydrogen. I'm not looking at this reaction, just I'm giving the example. Say for example, if I'm taking a formaldehyde, that time I'll be not having alpha hydrogen. That molecule is suppose if formaldehyde and ethanol both are reacting, that time I'll be getting only two products. Only two products I'll be getting. Suppose if both are having alpha hydrogen, that time I'll be having four possibility products. So just I'm going to give the number of four products. So here if you don't know about this concept, please go and watch my previous video in cross aldol condensation. You'll be getting a good idea about this. So here ethanol and propanol both are reacting dilute in presence of dilute NaOH. So initially the OH minus will act as a base that will always fix the beta hydrogen, alpha hydrogen. That alpha hydrogen will fix up, then nucleophile will be created. The nucleophile will able to attack another molecule of aldehyde which is having alpha hydrogen or without alpha hydrogen. Then the reaction will proceed to form a different products. And next one is a Cannizzaro reaction. What is a Cannizzaro reaction? The Cannizzaro reaction is nothing but So when aldehydes are ketone without alpha hydrogen, so without alpha hydrogen, there is no alpha hydrogen should be there. That it is otherwise called as a disproportionation reaction. Why it is called as a disproportionation reaction? Say for example, if I am taking alpha hydrogen absence aldehyde. Say for example, HCHO here, there is no alpha hydrogen. There is no alpha hydrogen means there is no alpha. Alpha carbon means there is no alpha hydrogen. So here it is a functional group, there is no alpha carbon, there is no alpha hydrogen. So here in presence of concentrated KOH, that time I'll be getting one oxidized product and one reduced product. This is my oxidized product and this is my reduced product. So here it got oxidized, here it got reduced. Here it has got reduction. So aldehyde is getting converted into alcohol and aldehyde is getting converted into acid salt. So by the way, this reaction is called both oxidation and reduction is taking place in a single molecule. That is what we called as disproportionation reaction. So here if I'm taking benzaldehyde, why it is a alpha hydrogen absence aldehyde, that we know that. So if you don't know about this concept, please go and watch my previous video in Cannizzaro reaction section. So here benzaldehyde will be taken and benzaldehyde with the concentrated KOH, I'll be getting benzyl alcohol and potassium benzoate as a salt. That's all about the Cannizzaro reaction. And next one is very important one, that is a Hell-Wohlgart-Zinsky reaction. We already discussed about the mechanism of this Hell-Wohlgart-Zinsky reaction. If you don't know about this concept, please go and watch my previous video like a Hell-Wohlgart-Zinsky or HVZ reaction section. So here alpha hydrogen containing carboxylic acid, that will be reacting in presence of a red phosphorus and halogen. That halogen may be chlorine or bromine. So if suppose the little bit amount of red phosphorus will be taken, if you taking little bit amount of red phosphorus, that will be reacting with the chlorine or bromine to form respective with phosphorus trichlorides. That phosphorus trichlorides will involving in the reaction to form alpha halo carboxylic acid. If I am taking acetic acid, I will be getting alpha halo acetic acid. The alpha hydrogen will be substituted. That is what the HVZ reaction or Hell-Wohlgart-Zinsky reaction. And next one is a very important one, that is a Gabriel thalidomide synthesis. So here thalic acid, here it is a thalic acid. If I'm reacting with amine to form amides, or thalic amide, thalimide, this is thalimide. The thalimide which is going to react with alcoholic KOH, that time this will be eliminated as water molecule. By the way, the K is substituted here. And if suppose the K and K I'll be getting, I am going to react with RX, alkyl halide or aryl halide. Particularly, it is used to prepare only aliphatic amine, so that here that R may be a alkyl group, not to be a aryl group. Here KX will be eliminated and R, NR will be substituted here. And if you hydrolyze this, I'll be getting 1° amine along with a thalic acid. So here, why the condition is here only used to prepare aliphatic amines, 1° amine, not to prepare aromatic amines. Because why I am not able to prepare aromatic amines in the sense, here N, K is there and RX is there. That R, if it is alkyl group, it is getting easily substituted. If it is a aryl group, it is a bulky one, which is not going to substitute here. That is what here I will not getting this kind of product. If I am not getting this product, if I hydrolyze this, I will not be getting this kind of aromatic amines. Okay, in that case, that is what I am unable to prepare aromatic amines. Here only I can able to prepare aliphatic 1° amines. And next one is a very important one, that is a Hoffmann bromide degradation reaction. If we want to prepare one carbon less product, that time you have to use Hoffmann bromide reaction. So here if I am taking acid amide, so here it is COOH, instead of that NH OH, I'll be getting NH2. That is what is called as CONH2 group is called as amide. So which will be reacting with the bromine and sodium hydroxide, and just we are going to heat this reaction, I'll be getting RNH2 amines. I'll be getting with the sodium carbonate, sodium bromide and water will be there. So here this bromine and NaOH will give the bromide mixture, bromide bromide mixture I'll be getting. So here two carbon containing amide is there and one carbon containing amine is formed. That is what I can eliminate. If I want to eliminate this molecule, if I want to eliminate this group, that is if I want to eliminate the CO group, that time I have to use this kind of Hoffmann bromide degradating agents like bromine and sodium hydroxide or bromine or KOH. That time I have to use NaOBr or KOBr. So amides can be converted into amines. For that important conversion, so one carbon less, that time we have to use this kind of reagents. I think so you understand well. Thank you so much for watching. Please go forward to others to get benefit. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you once again. Thank you. Thank you for learning. Share and like this video.